Hello viewers, welcome to my channel PC Duo Kimberly, a source of diamond. Today we are going to see an important topic from stratigraphy, that is the correlation. I am Dr. Saji Hundekar, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Geology, AKI, Spooner College of Arts, Science, Commerce, Camp Pune, Maharashtra, India. It is affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University, that is SPPU Pune, and formerly it is known as University of Pune. Correlation. Yes, what we are going to have, what is the correlation? That is whatever we are going to see in the stratigraphy, the laid rock with reference to the various parameter. Yes, what we have, vertical succession, horizontal succession, in sequence, correlation, fossil content. When you are going to make out these vertical column with the two different localities which are been disconnected. Say example, we have taken a rock column of 1 kilometer, the drilling data, and we have prepared a stratigraphic columns of a Pune area. Similarly, we have taken one similar age rocks which are exposed in Australia, Antarctica, or in India itself. Whether you can take any part from Karnataka, Andhra, or you can go for the Uttarakhand, and now we are going to try to make out the comparison between them to study these different stratigraphic columns with the very important one taken as the two important tool, the rock and the fossil. And second one, they should be of a same age. Determination of the time is important. So here the aim of a stratigrapher is to decipher the climate and the environments of the deposition of the sediment and the life which is existed at the time of the deposition. Often the rocks are of a different region, maybe the same age, but whatever the environmental condition, climatical conditions, whatever the deposition environment is there, it will be a totally different. So that we have to establish and try to make the comparison. So the equivalence we have to find out between the two different strata of the same age with the geochronological systematic columns. So such exercise will establish the equivalence of the geological age of two different types rock types is called as the correlation. This is what we are going to make out. Vertical succession, we are going to study the rocks in vertical succession. We are going to study in the horizontal succession, that is lateral extent, vertical extent, in sequence, then the fossil content, and now we want to compare the two different columns of the different stratas of the different remote areas of the within that particular part. Then that will be called as the correlation. Thus we are establishing their relation, and on the various factor, first one, they should be the age, very important one, the rock which have been there in Pune and there in Kutch area, say example, we have collected that this much column, we want to study as a 100 meters rock column. So that rock column should be of the same age. That is one, that is the dating of that particular rock which we are going to make out, the age should be same. The second one, once you have taken the age, then we have to make out the parameters. What, whether they have the same environmental condition, paleoclimatic condition at the time of deposition, what will be the environment, what types of rock is there, whether we have any index fossils will be available, any marker bed is there. So we have to make on that particular basis. And once we establish their ages, on that basis we can make out the correlation of the two different localities or rock strata we can serve. So correlation serves a group together. The rocks is in widely separated areas which have the same age, then establish the proper geological sequence. Then we can make out what will be the younger one, what will be the lower one. Once we establish the what we have, the marker bed we establish, and then onwards we can make and systematically we can correlate that two different localities. Hence the two geological rock units belonging to the different locations or local sections which we are said to be correlated if they are the time equivalent. See, if they have the time equivalent is there, then we can make out that particular part. So here the study grapher who are going to make out the correlation, he has to follow a method by which systematically we can determine the mutual time relation of these two different location, which sections which we have been selected. So correlation may be local or might be on the basis of the regional scale, and that is the essential part of the historical geology, because what we are going to make out the dating of that rock, what we have been collected, it might be million years or might be a billion years back it is there, and now we are correlating. So here it is a very, very important task which we have been making. So on the basis of that, we are going to build a global succession of the geological events. So whatever the geological succession which have been happening in geological event which have been taken place in Kutch area, similarly in Pune, so whether they have the same one or different one, so we can try to make out that systematic historical part of that particular global history of that particular areas of these two areas. So the correlation is an important tool of the stratigraphy, which helps to help you to unfold whatever the folded information is there. We don't know any information, but that has to be open, unfold the geological history of the continents and the distribution of land and water and the evolution of life and changes in the climatic conditions. That is the very, very important. So correlation is an important tool of stratigraphy, which helps to unfold the geological history of the continents and the distribution of land and sea, the evolution of life and the changes in the climatic, paleoclimatic condition, paleoenvironmental condition, so we can reconstruct them. So many deposits are characteristic of a particular period. For example, iron ores of Precambrian or coal deposits of Permacol. Every part of the world we are going to have these two are the very famous one. And now we have been only looking for the Permacol, then we have to see the whatever the geological time scale we have been prepared, whether the same rocks are exposed in Pune, whether the same rocks are there in Kutch, whether they are belonging to the Precambrian or whether they are belonging to the Permacol, that will be tested. But in Pune we don't say we have the Gondwanas of Deccan traps have been exposed, thus we have the different rocks. So I am taking the simple example. So correlation can make the locality, locating the rocks of the same age, prospecting for economic mineral. Why we want to study this correlation? So once you know the correlation, then we can make out that whether in India which particular mineral is important. Say example, if you got a gold, silver, copper, uranium, or oil and natural gas, if they are there as a reserve, we first scan the whole whatever we have, our area is there, we are trying to scan it out so that the wealth of our currency, rupees, can go on increasing as compared to the dollar. So economy has been based on the mineral content of our India. So we want to see what are the minerals are there. So locating the rocks of the same age, prospecting for economic mineral or the fossil, much easier. So like I am prospecting for oil and natural gas. So what we are there? Normally tertiary rocks. So in that tertiary, which one is there? Whether Eocene, Miocene, Pliocene or Pleistocene, or whether this one particular one is giving you a good stock, whether say example Bombay High we have or KG Basin is there, which particular type of rock is there, what is the age, whether the similar type of things which we are going to get at a Visakhapatnam or Kochi base, or whether it is on the Goa side, Bangalore side. So we can scan it out, that particular rock, that area with that particular, and try to match the lithology of these two different areas with what we have got in the KG Basin. So that will be the comparison, the correlation we can do it out to get the exploit, whatever the economic minerals which are available in our area, territory which is available. So correlation making, the locating the rocks of the same age, prospecting for economic mineral or the fossil, much easier. Thus the determination of equivalence of the age and stratigraphic position of two different formations, separated areas are termed as the correlation. That is the what we have, the definition of both the correlation. Now, the correlation is useful in studying what? The development and movement of the continental drift. So, when the earth has, what we have, the whatever the continent which are there at a one particular point, they have been united. That is a Pangaea. But at the end of the Paleozoic, they have been drifted and seven different continents have formed. And from that particular period, Mesozoic, Cenozoic, they have been traveling. So now at present, still the continents are moving now. So we want to see that the whatever the south plates are there, they are coming on the north side. North plate are going towards the south side. So we want to see what is the development which has been taken place. What is the movement of the continent and how the life has been evolved. Whether any particular organism, if you consider horse, elephant, tigers, how they have been evolved, we can study that particular part. Second important part of this correlation is that we can locate the economic mineral, oil, natural gas, gold, silver, uranium, whichever the mineral which can we can get in our territory, so we can exploit. So for them, we want to try to make out the comparison of the different whatever we have, the rocks which have been exposed in the different vicinities, and which particular rock is giving you a good deposits, we have to find out. Then the oil and natural gas, that is everyone who knows 80% of the oil and gas we have been importing in India. So a lot of whatever our wealth is there, we have been just putting in purchasing of these oil and natural gas. So we want to scan these our areas, whether similar rock which are there in a Bombay High or whether in a Kutch Basin or whether Ankleshwar, whether we have in Assam similar type of rocks of same age, whether we can get in some other areas so that we can get the good deposits of oil and natural gas so that we can become the self-reliance. So this is what we have the intention. For this purpose, we have to explore the petroleum material, oil, natural gas, coal basins. So this is what we have. But systematically, how we are going to make out the methods for the correlation? So there are the two important methods are there. The first method is physical and the second one is paleontological, that is called as biophysical and biological, or physical and paleontological. So we'll see one by one. Yes, the first one what we have is the physical evidence. The method for correlation we are going to focus on the what will be the physical evidences are there. So whatever we are going to have the tracing, similar characters of geological time and establishing the relation between the rocks with their environmental paleoclimatic conditions. So that will be the part mainly focused on based on the two important tool, rock and the fossil. So these correlations are short range correlations. So that we can make out short, then we can go in detail about that the continuity of the strata, how much the strata will be a continuous one, what will be the lithological similarities are there, then the what is the electrical characters, well long we can make out, and we, with the help of that we can make out the correlation, then radioactivity is there, marker beds we can find out, position in the stratigraphic sequence, uncomfortable sea relation we have to find out, and the structural development and metamorphism. So these are the various methods are there, or a criteria, important criteria are there for the correlation by physical methods. So we'll just first we'll start with the continuity of the strata, that is lateral continuity. Whatever the rock which are exposed horizontal on the surface or below the surface, at what particular level which rock is there, once we know that what is the thickness, we know what is the age of the rock, then what will be the fossil content is there, then we will try to find out that how much is the laterally it has been extended. So that we can trace out by taking the different drilling, or whether ups and downs are there, whether wherever it is exposed, we can make out that particular find. So there is a, this is our first simple method for a local scale we can find out the correlation. Then the second one, deposition of sediment generally takes place over a vast area. When these material are weathered and dissected by erosion, they form different and separated out curve. So that will be continuously you are going to say now whatever the hill is there, now it has been eroded and this part has been eroded. Now you can see this patch and this patch. We try to locate now A, this is A, but now A will be missing here. This is a B, B is here, this is also B. So some part of the A is remaining, but here the B is there, see there, that also there. Then you can see this particular part which we have, this is what we have the marker where you can see now, this is what we have here also, it is present here also present. So there are three different locations which have been exposed in that particular area. On the local level we can find out, and lower side you can see the limestone. So this is the way you have to make out the lateral continuity of the rocks or the beds. We can make out establishing a lateral continuity exposures of the same rock, trace one of the exposure to the other side. So similar beds will be there, which we have been just in the scene in the diagram. And now once you made one marker bed, that the characters we know and fossil which are there in that marker bed, what we are going to have? Guide fossils. These are the index fossils, or we called as the guide fossils, which are living for a short duration, and they can give you the correct age, and they will give you the correct environmental condition, the climatic condition of that particular bed. And on the basis, once you recognize them, then similar thing we can find out in that other small location, so that we try to make out the comparison. So that is the way we have to go and make out. On the basis of that similarity, what we are going to see, what is the lithology, what are the rock types are there, what will be the composition, what is the texture of the rock, what is the mineral, what is the grain size, if the sedimentary rock is there, grains will be come out, what is the grain size, what will be fabric, what will be the cementing material, what is the structure it show, what is the color it has been shown. And now once we have been seen that it is most of them are matching, then we will invite the comparison, then the leads to the similarity to the correlation. One by one everything is go on matching, then we will say they are the continuity is present horizontally. These criteria applied only for those rocks which occur in a single deposition basin, because similar lithology implies similar deposition element. If one bedrock is there, similar lithology is there, then what we are going to make out, that these beds are deposited in the same environmental condition. So that is the give you, then ultimately we can make out that they are been deposited in the same age. So that is the conclusion you go on making once you get the lot of information about that particular, the columns of the different local regions we have been got. So it has happened that similar condition may happen in the existed simultaneously in the several isolated areas. Say example, we have seen now say in a one particular area in a Pune, Shivaji Nagar, we have taken one column. Similarly, one Kundwa we have come, there we have taken one column. So distance is now not far as compared. We will see that only the 5 kilometers or 10 kilometer distance. Assume as a compared 10 kilometer is a devastated. Whether we are going to get the similar lithology, same rock, same composition, then the grain size, cementing material, then one by one we are going to, then we can reconstruct that these are the similarities, lithological similarities will be there, and on the basis of that we can make them the matching, that these are the continuation. So this is our conclusion which will be made with that particular part. Similarly one, so what we have the excellent example of the correlation of rocks of Europe has been successfully carried out with the Eastern North America. So there are the scientists who has done the studies of Europe, and they made the comparison with Eastern North America, and that has been successfully, they have been showed the lithology and the correlation has been done. So lithologies are constant enough to make the correlation of rock in it possible, both the similarity of the rock in it. So in that we are going to see textures, color, composition, then the stratigraphic positions of the established sequence, which will be the younger one, which will be the older one, what will be the youngest one. Then the once you made this one, then we can make the electrical properties. We will make that the geophysical instrument we use, we'll send the, we use the electrical resistivity method, or electrical electricity methods or magnetism, and we try to make out the litho logs or electrical log, and from that well logs we can make the comparison of these three different location. You can say that this is one and this is second. So now we can match with this, and perfectly we can correlate with the help of the electrical properties, with the help of the electrical logs. And the electrical character recorded in this log depend upon the physical characters of the rock. That is the main important. We are going to take the one as a rock and second one is the fossil. So in that rock, what we are going to say, that physical properties of rock. What the physical properties? Porosity, permeability, and the presence of oil and gas and water. That is the intention is there for the electrical one. The electrical characters are further modified by other factors like temperature, pressure, and the nature of the drilling mud. What type of drilling mud you are going to use in that. Similarly, the geophysical character implies a similarity in constitution rather than contemporaneously. The hell and geophysical properties are to be used correlation with the some precautions. So we have to take into the precaution, and there we are going to use the indirect method, and that is not going to does not establish the time equivalence with the certainty. But here this is the indirect method, but in that indirect method we have to take the important as the AH. There we cannot be make it out, but for this we have to make the dating of age. Now radioactive age determination, that is very important. So each rock contain the radioactive element. It is not been common everywhere, but some radioactive elements which are may be present in the rock, and they are continuously emitting the alpha, beta and gamma rays, and with the help of where these radioactive decay is there, we can with the help of the carbon dating, oxygen dating, or whether we have strontium or uranium thorium dating, we can find out or we can determine the age of the rock in case there is no fossil deposits are there. If the fossil is there, with the fossil and again with this the radiometric dating, we can try to make the comparison, and we want to make out the conclusion, whatever the nearest one, the age, perfect one or absolute age, we can of that rock we can determine on the basis of the radiometrics dating, and that will be the best way to make the correlation in space and time. The next one is a marker bed. That is a very very important in sedimentary rock. Whatever the what we have is the beds which have been deposited, and in that we are going to get a marker bed. In that marker bed, what we are going to have, that these are the contain the important index fossil or guide fossils, or they are the simply coal seams, bentonite clays or ash beds. They are the excellent marker beds and best way to establish the two different geological successions. So marker beds in the two succession are carefully studied, and similarly the younger and older and the relation has been maintained. Age will be the important establish with this help of the marker bed. Then the next one, very important one, stratigraphic position, order of superposition. How you are going to establish which will be the your younger bed and which will be the older bed with the help of that particular models, based on the primary tool, whether the rock and the fossils and the radiometric dating, all these we are going to take into the account, and we will try to make a proper sequence, and that sequence will be matched with the both the different localities, remote areas, and we can make the draw conclusion on the basis of their composition and the rock age determination. Then the stratigraphic position. Under the normal condition, the strata immediately below and above of these unit can be correlated in spite of their logical lithological development, and may be vary from place to place. When lithological similarity is not distinct enough to permit the correlation, then position of the same unit in the local stratigraphic succession may be conveniently used for the correlation. So correlation will be of two level. Fossiliferous bed may establish the correlation of an intermediate unfossiliferous sequence, and intervening the positive errors data showing more or less extreme variation. So we can see very carefully now, here we have the fossil which are there, same fossil we have been there, then here we have the marker bed is there, that marker bed will establish similar marker bed we have here. So we will, with the help of the fossil, try to locate them, how much thickness will be there and how much thin will be there. So this is the way we are trying to make out the stratigraphic position. Then the next one, unconformable relation, that is also a very important one, unconformities, whether the whatever the rock vertically they have been deposited. Now these rocks are always exposed to the atmosphere and they are undergoing for the weathering, and that part we have to take into the account wherever we can get the unconformities and check it out on the both the section whether any unconformity is there. About this, how you are going to identify the unconformity, that wherever unconformity is there, we have the conglomerate is there, there is the time missing is there, which is the lower rock, upper rock is there. So we have to see that particular part and make out or draw conclusion whether this four types of conformities, that is angular unconformity, disconformity, local unconformities, non-unconformities, which are the unconformities which have been available in that in these two different sequence which we have been making out. So in that, the wider concept we are going to make out, and the age, which will be the younger one and which will be the older one, in these two factors we can try to make the comparison. In vertical thickness, these two vertical, two unconformities similar to one another in a vertical sequence, if the rock below are the older unconformity, can be correlated, then rock occurring in the between these two unconformities can be roughly correlated. So once one base has been confirmed, then over and upper whatever the rocks which are there, we will try and try to make out in the comparison, the correlation we can easily record that. So that is the very very important one, structural development and the metamorphism. So there is how much degree of metamorphism has taken place and how much the deformation has been taken place due to the whatever the forces which are acting. So we have to find out the angular unconformity, whatever the tectonical plates are also playing a vital role to make out the various complex four structures which are going to form, like Appalachian Mountains, Eastern United States of the Appalachian Mountains of Eastern United States and mountains of Newfoundland, Greenland, that is North Europe, has perfectly correlated on the basis of the fold mountains. So these are the category which will be has to be find out by each one, and the grade of metamorphism is very considerably from place to place. Sometimes we are going to get the polymetamorphism, so we have just a one type. So these grades of metamorphism, how much it is there, whether pressure, heat, how much they are evolved, what type of metamorphism which have been happening, and how many times it has gone under the metamorphism, whether the polymetamorphism has been taken place, we have to reconstruct that. For example, Bundelkhand gneiss have been correlated with the peninsular gneiss of South India on the basis of the comparable grade of metamorphism. In the present oceans, the finer sediments drift toward the greater depth while the core sediments are deposited near the shore. That is the what we have orderly variation is there on the lithology. On the basis of that, the present day oceans which are there, that will be going to give you the feedback to make out when you are going to see. The present is the key to the past. So we have to see whatever the present activity which is happening on the surface of the earth and take into the account, and we will see that in the back whatever the thing which is happening, we want to make that and try to identify them. So this is a very very important one. Then the orderly variation in the lithology. So there will be a lot of changes may take place because whatever the happening in that area, we don't know, because already the things that happened, we just have to analyze that whatever the sequence of rock vertically they are exposed in that particular area, which rocks have been gone under weathering, how much they have gone, whether one bed, two bed, three bed are missing, we don't know. So we have to regularly find out what is the succession is there in a vertical lithology, that has to be make out with the help of the correlations. Then the next one, methods for correlation is the paleontological evidences. So fossil is an important reliable tool for stratigraphing. So there also we have the fossil which are there for living for 24 hours. What we have, they will give you more light than those who have been having, especially the marine, whatever the particular environment they have been suited. So we will see that how these fossils which we have got from the beginning up to the present, whatever we have, the data of the fossil is there. From there we can study how this organism is evolved. Say example, mammals, or we have the monkeys, horse, elephant, how they have been evolved systematically from the various geological ages we have to try to make out. And that is the based on whatever the scanty fossil data we have there. Because 10 million means 1 million means 10 lakh fossil animal plants are there, and from there we can get only one fossil. So that much scanty record is there, and from that record we want to establish the what we have, the correlation. And the William Smith is the first stratigrapher to correlate the geological strata on the basis of fossil and lithological similarities. And the correlation is based on paleontological evidence, is carried out on the one by one methods. First one, guide or index fossil. Yes, definitely 100% it will be there in your MCQs. Define or what is the index fossil? Index fossil is one which is a distinct morphology, has a particular morphology, vast population. Yes, it is a have a population on geological, geographically they are widely distributed and capacity to throw, and they have a capacity to throw any environment, very wide distribution in space and limited distribution in time. They are very short, whether maybe 24 hours they may be there, or they may be 2 days, 4 days. So that variation, so within that particular time, whatever the climate is there, we can systematically study, and once we know them, then we can easily date that particular rock and that particular fossil. We call them as a guide, or we call them as an index fossil. For example, here we have matched this one as the Phylomollusca class lamellae branch. So here they are matched. So wherever they are there, we are going to match them. Then similarly on the lower side, this particular. So this is the way they have been matching. So this is not been going to match with this, because here the two different positions are there, what type of fossil which are required. So on the basis of that, we are going to make out the systematic vertical succession and made the comparison very well in that correlation. So presence of an index or guide fossil is very useful in correlation. For example, fossil of cephalopod is present in all sections. Such distribution is not only shown by the fossil brachiopods, lamellae branch, coral. So we have their population is very huge, and they are everywhere they are found. So we will take them to make the comparison of the two different localities which have been separated by a remote distance what we have. So thus, on the basis of the presence of cephalopods, the beds can be correlated. Hence the geological section which will be widely separated by one another can easily correlate it. And once you know that stratigraphic columns, then we can focus it out, what are the economic minerals which will be available in that vicinity, whether we can get oil or natural gas or coal deposit, any mineral particularly that will be give you a wealth. And on the basis of that wealth, automatically the currency of your rupees will be in the international market will go on rising if we have good deposits are there. So for example, the peridotite trilobites is also one of the important index fossil which lived about 550 million years ago. 1 million means 10 lakh. Now you can multiply 10 lakh into 550. So this much duration what we have, about which the fossil peridotite, the trilobites are there, and they have been established. Three types of fossil are recognized in any fossiliferous sediment. These are index fossil, composition fossil, or local fossil. If index fossils are absent, then entire fossil assemblages has to be considered for correlation. If we could, sometime we could not get the index fossil, then we have to go for some other alternatives, fossils, for them to make the comparison. Cosmopolitan, yes, there will be mixing, so many animals, plants will be living in that particular area, and we want to have the wider distribution. Not only they are there only restricted for the smaller area, if they have been widely distributed all over the globe, then it is having a very great importance when you are going to make use them as a index or the guide fossil. Endemic fossils, being the local, are not been much used. They are only the limited one in the endemic fossil, so they are not been used. But those fossil which are have wide distribution and the number of population is also very high, are such fossils, and we will use it for the correlation. So here you can see now this fossil, here we have made this fossil, this. So this is the way you are coming on. This fossil is here, this fossil is here, it is not. So this is the way you are going to make, with the help of that particular fossil, we will make the fossil assemblages, and we try to make out the how these beds are deposited, and the sequence will be, generally we will made systematically arranged, and it will be published. What thing we have been done in the correlation, that will be a very useful. Initially, the least one of the beds should be correlated on the basis of index fossil. Whenever you want to make the established, the first one, a thin layer of index fossil assemblages we have to take from the two areas, and we want to make the comparison on the basis of their age. First one, age factor. Second one, their composition. What is the composition? What is the structure? What is the skeleton? Then we'll have the third one, whether they have deposited in the same environmental condition. And once you've done this one, then we will make out the stratigraphic sequence with the help of that particular index fossil, like a trilobites and cephaloids. They have been used so many times to make the comparison of that particular vertical whether or horizontal one. So these use for correlation at section 2, 3, 4. So multiple purpose you can make out them and make the comparison. Now similarly, when you are going to make out the, once you establish the comparison, then that will be useful how that particular fauna or flora has been evolved, then the evolution part, morphological parts, then nomenclature. So everything will be taken into the account, and once you are done, then we say that from that particular part it has been evolved. So the evolution part, the geological time scale, with comparison with the geological time scale, we try to make, construct a evolution process for any particular organism. So that will be the very, very important one for finding the ages, and after that the making the establishment of successful evolution of that particular fossil, like ammonites. They are extinct in the Cretaceous, but Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous, how they are evolved and how they are extinct. So everything we will make out systematically, so that has to be kept into the record. And we have to make the, once you know the marker of guide fossils, the younger and older rocks, we can make, compare, and on the basis of that, the fossil assemblages will be done, and they will be compared. That will be the correlation we can establish with the help of the fossil event. Similarly, in the case of the trilobite, there are a lot of evolution trends are there in the trilobite. Whether right from the in the head, thorax, pygidium, in the size, shape, similarly genal angle, genal spine, so there is a variation is there. Facial suture, there is a variation is there. Then globella also, there is a variation, increasing or decreasing of the globella. But then the facial suture, how many are there, that will be there. Then how is the thorax will be evolved, how is the pygidium is evolved, how the tail of that particular trilobite has been evolved. So that will be there. So number purpose we have to make out, and investigation has to be done, so that we can reconstruct whatever the morphology of the primitive to the recent one, and once on the basis of that, what are the changes which have been seen in that particular genera and why it has been extinct, the question has been arrived. So that is the very, very important aspect for the finding of that the ages and the evolution part we can study with the help of the with the fossil content, whatever the fossil content which are available on the above the marker bed as well as below the marker bed, and the geological evolution history we can make out of the fauna as well as flora. And for this, rock and the fossil, these are the two important tools we are taken into the account, and on the basis of that the correlation has been done. I hope from my side I clear. If you have any doubts, write down in the description. I can just give you the answer to, or sometime I can make again a video if you not understand this particular topic thoroughly. Thank you. Have a nice day.